You mentioned that this motor on the thumper is the same that's in these subs. Would you be able to tell us more about that?
Yeah, let's go check it out.
So this is one of the Super Sub 30s that we just heard. And you were telling me earlier that they operate on a different principle than a normal speaker might.
When you have a magnet, speakers will have a magnet, usually a round magnet, and then you have a coil of wire. You can see this is a horn diaphragm. And when you have electricity or current flowing through a coil of wire that's immersed in a magnetic field, it will want to move in one direction or the other. In fact, you can give that a shot. Why don't you give that a try there?
Oh, I see. Oh, man, it's a strong magnet. So then this is a DC source, so it's either, if I have it one direction, it's pulling in, mm-hmm. the other direction, it's going to push out?
Yeah, I mean, with music, it would alternately push and pull, and then we'd hear what's going on. This is an EVX 180. We used to use those in the old rat subs. So there's typically two things. You have your surround, which keeps the edge of the cone straight. And then you have your spider, which is this guy down here. We'll see that in a second. And your spider keeps the voice close straight. Together, the two support systems keep the voice coil centered in the gap. Right, so there we go. There's our coil of wire here. This is an aluminum flat wound, I can tell by looking at it. They make it sometimes copper, it's heavier, but they'll sound different. And it's wound on a former. And flat wound means it's a flat wire that's wound on edge instead of just using round wire. And then there's our gap, similar to this guy here.
This is both magnetic, is that right?
No, the magnet is this guy right underneath. So the magnetic circuit is one side of the magnet, the North Pole, let's say, comes up, hits this plate, and then that energy shows up here. The other side of the magnet touches this cup, and it transfers the magnetic energy through the metal all the way around onto a ring that sits here, and then brings the magnetic field. So you have a gap. So you have the two sides of the magnet are right on either side of this ring. And that's what we see here.
So it's like a moving coil microphone in reverse. If you have a moving coil microphone, there's a coil of wire around a magnet. And when you cause motion to the coil of wire, in proportion or in relation to that magnet, it'll create electrical current.
Right. This is exactly correct. And then and the reverse happens. It's reciprocal. So we can show that as well. So here's a speaker. And this will generate electricity when we move it. I'm going to take it off. See how it's making, and you can feel the energy kind of. So it's creating electricity, and we're shorting it out, and we're hearing kind of the noise remnants of that happening.
And you could do the same thing here, right? If you, maybe you don't want to do it for too long to heat up or anything, but if I hold this here, it pulls in. Actually, is that pushing or pulling?
That's pulling.
That's pulling. But if I switch the polarity of the source, it's going to push out.
And you can do that on the big one, too.
Oh, nice. So here's pushing out, pulling in. And I guess if you put this on a drill bit and spun it really quickly, it'd be positive, negative.
Yeah, you get square waves.
Kind of what we are dealing with audio, not square waves, but alternating current, which results in a push and a pull. So how is this different from what we have going on here in the Super Sub?
Okay, so let's grab our wire. All right, so this is a linear drive motor. It's called an M-Force, and it was designed by Claudio over at PowerSoft. And this has instead of having a coil of wire immersed in a magnetic field attached to a cone, it's got a flat paddle with four magnets on it, and then these two huge slugs of coils of wire. It's actually wire wound like a flat wire wound round and round into immersed in and potted into a solid entity in these side plates. And this paddle is between those two steel immersed coils of wire. And what happens is, instead of it being round, you've got this huge paddle and it's a moving magnet. Normally the coil moves. And one of the challenges with moving coils is you have to attach electricity to the coil. It means you got these flexible wires attached to it. If you make the wires too strong, they're heavy and they break. If you make them too thin, they lose a lot of energy and get hot. So you have a lead wire conundrum. This has got a moving magnet. So the coils of wire are fixed into this huge slug. So the paddle is attached to, the four magnets are on this paddle, and it's a fiberglass form, and it's attached to this bolt. And this bolt, we actually screw onto this high-density polyethylene cone. It's like what trash cans are made of, super strong stuff. And it just is bolted on, and it can move this. This thing is so strong, it'll break your finger. You hold a stiff finger to this thing moving at full power. I mean, you saw what it did with that drum seat. It'll take your whole body and fling it. So these things are quite powerful, a little bit dangerous, and very fun. So these are what's in the Super Sub. Now, what I'm doing is I'm modifying these from, I'm adding this bottom frame on here, which has another spider on it. Here's the cones. So these are the old cones, and it was attached here, and it's a standard cone with a bolt in the middle. And what I'm doing is I'm upgrading them to these that have the same attachment point, but it's also got this secondary spider mounted here that gives it more alignment. So what was happening with these ones is when it was being driven hard, one side of this was getting hotter than the other, it was becoming softer, and the cone was rocking, and that was putting stress in the motor and on the cone and causing premature failure. So now with this second spider, you can't move this side. It'll move this way, but it can't move side to side. So it forces it to stay aligned onto that motor shaft. So it should increase its long-term power handling and allow me to turn it up a little louder.
So once the speaker is inside the cabinet, we put this, which has the amp mounted on the back?
Yeah, let's flip it over and we can look at the amp from the side of it. So, yep, watch your fingers. Yep. So the amp is encased in this sealed shell. This is acoustically or fully watertight, airtight. And then there's a connection for the speaker here and a connection for the pressure sensor. This will nestle in and bolt with a bunch of screws. There's a pressure sensor down in here that has a tube, an air tube that attaches to it, and it's got two outlets. This is a little hole on one side that can detect the pressure inside the back of the chamber here. And then there's a quarter inch tube that goes through the edge of the cone out to the front and detects the pressure in the front of the cone, and it looks for a differential. If the cone was to crack, or for some reason those pressure differentials are not similar, right? Equal and opposite, it can shut down the motor and put it into protect. You have control over those parameters. So if the motor fails, you're not sitting there running all this juice and creating a fire or something. So it's actually it tells that things are going on. You can actually go farther and have it measure the pressure and set it for linearity and alter the signal that it's sending to the motor to make sure that it's following a linear excursion, but I don't do that. I just use it for protection.
In all of these, why use this special design rather than the more typical moving coil design?
That's a great question. A typical speaker does not have the ability to really go much. It's very difficult to get a cone speaker to go below 28, 25 cycles. These are tuned at 23 and a half cycles, and they can tune lower. This thing, you can run power into that motor, and it'll move its full motion extremely slow. You can't get a normal speaker to do that because of the inductance and the the heat dissipation. This coil, on a normal speaker, that coil is sitting in air, right? And then there's a magnetic field around it. In this, the coil is embedded in a steel iron block. So its ability to dissipate massive amounts of heat order of magnitude more than a normal speaker would be able to do. If we take this, what we'll do is I have a function generator on here. Okay, so this is frequency, that's 20 hertz. Now we got some. That's 31, 25 hertz. That's 23. Come feel this.
Really cool.
Yeah. Wow.
Well, thank you, Dave, for showing us around. If you haven't seen Dave's YouTube channel, use the link in the description below to check out some of his videos. We'll see you next time.